John Williams is an American film composer and conductor. He's best known for his work with Spielberg and Lucas, and to name some of his very high-profile films, he has scored Jaws, Star Wars, E.T., Indiana Jones, and the first three Harry Potter films. Possibly his first soundtrack was Valley of the Dolls in 1967. He has certainly done many more since. I couldn't find a decent list that I could try and count from, and I couldn't be bothered to. Oh, I just know there's loads. He's also composed a good number of concertos, orchestral works, and chamber music. Hi, my name's Dan, and before we launch into the review, I just wanted to say very quickly that this is a milestone in my reviewing, in the list from 3,000 at the bottom, all the way up to 1. Claim Music, we have got to the one that is at position 2222, which is four little ducks in a row. Have I got my ducks in a row? Almost certainly not. Okay, that was that bit. Let's get into the review. So this album is the score album from the film Star Wars. Have you heard of it? I think there's a chance that you probably have. It's a double album. It's one of the most successful soundtrack albums ever. And curiously, it was originally released such that if you had the, let's see if we can do this visually, if you had the two albums, they were kind of starting with side one, side four, side two, side three. And the point of that was the, old people like me will remember record decks with things called auto changers where you could stack a load of records on top of each other. So you could do this with LPs. And the reason for the sequencing there was that you could put them on as a stack and get side one, side two, and then you could pick them up and turn them over. Ooh, have I got this the right way around? And then you get side three, and so yeah, side three, and then side four as it comes down. And so you only had to actually change once with an auto changer. Which was an interesting thing, I found, but I'm that kind of geeky person who likes these things. Description, right, so it's almost entirely orchestral classical music, apart from one track, which is called the Cantina Band, which is pseudo-jazz with steel drums and synths and all sorts of other things as well. In the album, it sticks out like a sore thumb. In the film, it worked because it's music that's been played in a space bar that's full of many alien types and is designed to have a kind of synthy, futuristic, but also jazz feel to it. And I understand that some people love it and some people hate it, a bit like Jar Jar Binks. Although I think the hatred for Jar Jar Binks is possibly stronger than it is for the Cantina Band track. The rest of it, though, let's get back to it, is orchestral music. Kind of Romantic period and beyond, from my little understanding of classical music. It's a mixture of some recognizable themes, and there's, if you know the film, and I think a lot of people do, you will spot several of these themes that come through, and they just come back in different arrangements. You've got different bits in between, and you've got, Princess Leia's theme and whatever. So different arrangements and combinations, different feels you got, and feel is what good film music is all about. So menace, romantic, stirring, mysterious, even kind of alien at times. Sometimes there's kind of more stretching, discordant and complex harmonies and stuff like that. So not all of it would fit as kind of very melodic classical music. In fact, it's kind of, it's moving into the romantic, but it's also a little bit beyond, as I say. Sometimes it reminds me more of something like Stravinsky than certainly something like Mozart. I find it interesting that film music has been a huge area of orchestral classical music in a way that kind of contemporary classical hasn't been. And it's been this has been where a lot of what most of the my understanding of classical music has been, it's been preserved in film music in a way that's good. But the interesting, or an interesting thing I think here is that a lot of film music is very functional and is really about How do we get a feeling to back up the what's going on the screen, and it's very much serving this purpose. But John Williams' stuff, and Star Wars was very definitely in this, is that actually the music itself took on a life of its own, and it had these themes that are very, very recognizable. And I think his first that really did that was Jaws. Very recognizable theme in Jaws. And I would say that there is an expansion of this that's now going on, which is game music. Video game music has started to get into this same area of orchestral, classical, some of it contemporary, some of it not. There's a real mixture of music that goes into games these days. Back to this album. Does it work as an album? So this is the question that I kind of ask quite often of soundtrack albums, is that sure, they're a memento of the film. If you really enjoy the film and you want to be reminded of it, stick on the, buy the soundtrack album, stick it on. And they're a spin-off from the, merchandising from the film. You've had to make this soundtrack anyway. Why not sell it? And I guess the other question with this is, does it work as a classical composition? Because it is predominantly classical music. So does it work as, if you play it as an album, does it feel like a, a classical suite, something like the, Holst Planets or something like that. So I would say you're unlikely to hear the whole of this album done as a classical concert piece in its entirety. I think you're very likely to hear the main theme done. And I think quite often you can get suites of John Williams. Suites, that's the wrong word, a medley of John Williams music at a concert. I might be wrong, and if you know that there is this album performed in its entirety in concert, then I'd love to hear about that. As an album, it's not too bad, actually. It's not ridiculously tied to knowing the film, although I have seen the film a few times. Just how much of a difference does that make? I don't know. Most of the time, I can't listen to a bit and say, oh, yes, that's such and such a scene. So I don't have that connection with it. I don't know it that well. But I think my big criticism of it as an album is that it's too long. So a single album, I think, could have been tighter and could have been better and it could have been more rounded as an experience, as an album listening experience. So, yeah, if it was tightened up, it could have had a higher score from me. Although 7.7, which is what I've got it down as, is not a bad score. And especially for a soundtrack album, I guess. But it is, some of this stuff is really classic stuff that is very, very recognizable. So, bit of a mixed, feeling from me, but generally, yeah, what's not to like? But I'd love to know what you think, as always. Now, my son is over there in the, yeah, you can't see him because he's behind the camera. And he's just spoken, and I'm not sure if that's allowed. So I might have to bleep that out. We'll see. But he's just said that when I was just been recording another video before, one for Manassas, and he was saying, oh, some people challenge people to do things with a subscribe, etc. And he suggested that I should challenge you to use your, what was it, pinky toe to do a subscribe, like, and comment. And that this is a thing that'll actually get people to do this. I'm not convinced myself, but I said I would say this. So here's your challenge. Please leave a comment with your toe. If it comes all out all garbled, then I'll understand why. But also, I don't often do subscribe, give me a like, please. These things are appreciated. And that's it from me for now.